just want to come and sit on it.
A miracle of nature, a work of art, a feat of engineering. And it's yours, from the lightning forks of your blood vessels to the labyrinths of your fingerprints. It's all for you, whatever it does. Whatever it doesn't do, it has tricks up its sleeve. It has ways of making you talk. Maybe you can teach it to dance. Maybe you can let it render you speechless, incandescent with bliss, surprise or joy.
The world tends to make it seem a little bit more complicated than that.
It's important to protect yourself and your partner from unintended consequences. Just go for it. While tempting, it's not good advice here. You must be prepared. Use protection. This is a condom. It helps protect against STIs and unwanted pregnancy during penetrative sex with a penis 98% of the time. It can also be used to keep shared sex toys clean using a new condom for each partner. And this is a dental dam, or oral barrier. If you do not have one, you simply fashion one out of a condom. It can be used during oral, vaginal, or oral anal sex using a different dam for each partner or area. Latex or latex alternative gloves may be used for digital penetration. As keen as you may be to get going, it's advisable for the comfort of you and your partner to use a safe water-based lubricant. This helps to relieve friction, reduce the risk of tearing a condom, damaging delicate tissue, and many find that it maximizes enjoyment.
Must come down.
On screen, people have unprotected sex all the time. And then you just lie there in bed together.
Yeah, or like rejoin a cocktail party.
Yeah, or go off and fight crime. It would have been really nice to know that that is not what happens. Instead of just finding out on the night.
I was having sex with my partner, just having a great time, and then I felt this sudden pain. It felt like my womb had been punched in the face.
Have you been injured in an accident during sex? As with all physical activities, accidents do happen, be it a pulled muscle, a banged head, or in this lady's case, a penis hitting the cervix. Sex isn't supposed to hurt, so if you find yourself in this situation, the best thing to do is to stop. Wait until you feel ready to carry on. Or try something else.
Discomfort can be avoided with reduced force, adjusted angle and foreplay so that the muscles are relaxed and the cervix is raised. Partners not showing patience and compassion in this situation need to unwind themselves. If pain persists, see a doctor.
You. happens. But I was sorry if it had all one or me going to make it happen. I'm not bold. I'm fine, I'm not wrong with this. In fact, I smile, I laugh, I tell jokes. I go to the cinemas, I play games. I'm good. I go walk, I play music, I run around. I'm quite thankful, I don't see what I'm talking about. It's just the same old bit off the girl's dress. It's hardly the most interesting and exciting thing to do. I mean, it's free, I'm flying, I'm trying. There's a lot more things we can be doing, you know. You've got to look.
Love this tune. Top tune, yeah. But I actually had just like a few improvements. I think it's going. So there's girls and there's boys who like boys, not just girls. And there's boys who like girls, or both girls and boys. And it always should be someone you really, really desire to have sex with, you feel the same way. But you, there's boys, and there's girls, and there's boys, and there's people who identify as neither girls nor boys. And it always should be someone you really understand what you're talking about yourself, being trusted in the same you too.
There is nothing inherent in the human brain that associates ourselves with the social behavioural patterns assigned to gender. Like
No, gender is entirely biological. There are inherent, innate differentiating factors between males and females.
Gender is actually in wholly fluid. It depends entirely. No.
It's a mix.
I love that. But you can't change your gender just based on behaviour. Come on.
It's chromosomes. Your gender is decided before you get your sex organs.
What?
You...
It's experimental!
Gender is bullshit. It's oppressive. Yeah? It's a total waste of time. Hey!
My gender's really important to me!
No!
Okay!
Right, okay, so let's say sex is what's between your legs. And gender is what's between your ears. So, if we start with a really narrow definition of gender, then we have a binary of male and female. Other cultures have more, but in the West we predominantly recognise two. So then within that you have straight people who are attracted to the opposite sex, and then homosexuals, so lesbians and gay men who are attracted to members of the same sex, and then bisexuals who are I tried to suppose. But then these categories begin to break down when we get to people such as intersex people, for whom the body has features that are usually typical of a mixture of sexes. So this is not just sex organs, which is the most commonly discussed, it's also the skeleton, chromosomes, and internal reproductive organs. And then after that we get to trans folk, whose gender they always find at birth, transitioning from one primary gender to another and adhering to the expectations that go with it sometimes. But sometimes this involves pushing the boundaries of what all of these gender expectations are. Or sometimes just throwing all those gender expectations out the window. Which leads us on to queer identity, which basically questions and rubbishes the whole gender binary itself. I mean, you may be gender fluid, while your gender identity shifts from one to the other. Or you might incorporate various gender identities into your life. You might mark yourself out as a gender that's separate from the other, you know, or you might see yourself on a spectrum. Or you might see yourself as a gender and reject wholesale that classification. All you can really know is who you are, so the most important thing is just like you do you, like 100%, and support everyone else to do them, and stand up for them when they need you to, just believe them, even when their experience is different from your own. Okay?
Who by contrast have always been meek, chaste and passive by their nature throughout history.
Yeah!
if we actually go back through history, we see something of a reversal. We find that women were not always the ones to be seen as so helpless and reluctant after all. In fact, it was women who were seen to be the ones who could not simply control their sexual voracity, and that women's boundless, lascivious appetite would bring men to ruin. In 1497, the Malleus Maleficarum, or Hammer of Witchcraft, warned that all witchcraft comes from the carnal lust, which is women's infidelity. Even in the age of information, with the benefit of hindsight, stereotypes still heavily influence our idea of what is moral, what is normal, and what is possible. Biological how they are wired to feel about sex is generally exaggerated, if it even exists at all.
Worry about it. They should teach you to trust yourself.
Listen to yourself. Now that I know how it feels to want it, well, it makes it a little bit easier not to be convinced, but people say things like...
Come off it. You were well up for it a minute ago.
Then why did you invite me up?
Are you a pussy or frigid?
If you love me, you want to.
Go on. You came on to me. You let me on.
Artistry. There's no stopping this man, Josh.
tattoos, Josh?
Yeah, actually,
I feel really good. I've been training really, really hard for this. You see that 540? I've got to say, personal better.
Thank you, Dan. Josh, do you have anything to add?
I hate that gummy. Like, it's just all about him. I might as well just not even be here.
No, you know what? I'm going. That's it. No.
Josh, wait. Maybe we just need to all write down what Atticus looks like. Because, you know, it can be sexy and fiery and spontaneous once you learn how to listen to your partner and communicate, just to make sure that you keep.
So, will you do it?
I really enjoy it. having someone taking that responsibility, because I feel that at work I have to make so many decisions. I have to be in control. And I don't want to spend all my life being in control. Oh, it feels so nice having someone taking up that for me. I feel this is a big appeal of this kind of relationship. Being so submissive and being told what to do. It feels nice. Especially in this high-pressure days at work when everybody is here. Well, what do you think about this? Should I do this? Should I do that? Is it okay? Is it okay, Leila? But to come home and have someone to say, do this, and this. And maybe you'll get a word, but only if you are me. Honestly, really good. I like this. I like it. It's relaxing. It feels cathartic. Hello, Nicholas. I mean, these guys are great, obviously, but. It's nice to have a bit of time to yourself. So I thought you might fancy a song about masturbating. It's something we haven't touched on yet, but for many of us it was really the beginning, so I'll just play it to you. If you help out with the laundry, then nobody can complain, as long as it's all consensual. And not like to strangers on the train. That's a song, we've been through this. Self and love could be the very best kind of love. Your heart is never won, your brain would be unprecedented, or pretty damn impressive if you got yourself pregnant by mistake. Self love could be the very best kind of love. It's something that most people do. It not only feels terrific, it's a highly scientific way of finding out what feels good to you. Masturbation, foreign for recreation. Even in a long-term relationship, a little me time can be nice. It's like they say, to love someone else, first you've got to love yourself. There's no shame in masturbating. Don't let them tell you other. Don't let them tell you otherwise.
So, what do lesbians do in bed? Well, they can do everything, but doesn't involve a penis. So, oral sex, mutual masturbation, and use of sex toys. But I know what you're thinking. There is some contention over scissoring. Is it a myth propagated by pornography? Is it standard practice? How do you aim something the size of a pea accurately and repeatedly at something else the size of a pea? Well, everybody's different. So some people swear by it, and some people swear against it, and some people just swear during it.
The logistics aren't even really that strict. Scissoring or trimming, as it's also known, doesn't have to be a direct contact between two clitorises. It can also just be rubbing up against whatever body part you stood on. Also, you know, bending your knees and not being dressed in a scissor costume probably helps. And then this really weird thing starts to happen. It's like you just kind of start filling up with this like contentment and joy and happiness, and like you just really want to open up to the other person, like, and you tell them everything, like your hopes and dreams and fears and your pink hand.
I guess you probably want to go again.
Yeah, no, that's cool. Oh, wait, John. So, what do you want on your socks? Is that okay? I know it's meant to be really embarrassing, but it's been cold.
It's winter time, I would say. I kind of think that
it's winter time.
What about sex on the beach? Like, that kind of thing.
Yes!
Shut up!
This just ask that
question. Just ask serious. For a minute. I just, it's all fun and games and just the costumes, but like, it feels like it's all right for us. I mean, we're not gonna get beat up or shamed, like no one's gonna worry about
it. That's
the
point. Like, it's about having fun.
Yeah.
Sure. Sex supposed to be a laugh.
World, you're, it's a big world, universe, but like,
it's about being safe, but not just safe, like we need to be amazing. Mm-hmm. We need to have an amazing time. Just, yes. And, we need to enjoy. Like, just being humans among other humans. Just, you can't keep on like trying to stop us from doing that because it's amazing, like, it's too good. Go.
You know that moment, yeah, and you're with your like partner, and like that person's got stretchy skin, and like you make a smile, and then she's got so much, just pimples.
Biggest person ever too, and you end up being the little spoon anyway. Yeah.
Really nice. And when you're normally the little spoon, and you fit really nicely underneath their shoulder, or sort of armpit. I mean, it can get sweaty. But
well, like when you wake up in the morning, you see them, and you know you're gonna have a great day.
When they think you're asleep.
Or when you both have an amazing orgasm. Beautiful, you both.
Or like, when you are spooning and you get that very awkward dead arm, but you just go along with it because you love him.
Or like when you just end up rolling around in the mud for some reason.
Yes, I've done that. Like, stop it.
And you just love each other, everything's perfect, it's gorgeous, I love everything.
We're just going to have a quick break and then do the Q&A afterwards. So.